was right here.
You sure you have the right place?
I'm fucking sure it was right fucking here. Somebody saw me here, and they moved it.
Why would anyone do that, senor? You do realize by coming in here unaccompanied, you're trespassing.
Gate was open.
Still trespassing. Look, senor, perhaps you were mistaken. It's a very common car. Maybe there was a similar car to your daughter's and the owner just happened to come and pick it up when you came for me. Who knows?
I know. I fucking know. The goddamn plates were on the car. I told you that.
Pues, unfortunately, Señor Beckwith, we see this sort of thing all the time. A gringo, like you, finds out someone he loves has disappeared close to the border. And he just points his finger south at all those dangerous brown people living just across the bridge.
Don't play that bullshit card with me. You got that?
As I've said, Mr. Beckwith, there's no proof your daughter or her friend ever even came here to Juarez.
Her friends came here to party. They saw them. They got no reason. I said the fucking plates were on the car. It's her car.
Perhaps. Unless these so-called friends are the ones responsible for their disappearances in the first place. You should go home, Mr. Beckwith. This is no place for you. I told you, if we find anything, I will call you. Officer Sandoval here will escort you back to the border.
What? You promised to keep us safe. You didn't. Get out.
you to mean it, you know? She's just hurting, like the rest of us.
No. She meant it. And she's right.
Sean, you didn't know where she was going. Neither of us did. She knew how we felt about her crossing the border. That's why she didn't tell us.
When she left for school, I was sick for a week. I didn't tell you, but every day, sick to my stomach. Yeah, I was worried about Daddy's little girl in the big city, the big dangerous city. Then she comes home for one day, one fucking day. She wanted to bring Lauren.
What are you doing? This is bad enough already, without imagining how it could be worse. What happened today? What's going on, Sean? You're talking like it's hopeless. Look at me. Don't believe that. I can't. Where did you get this?
Lee's car.
Where?
Where is? Impound lot somewhere outside the city.
Oh, no. I mean, was there any sign?
No. There was nothing, nothing I could see, no struggle.
That's good, right? You told the police?
Yeah. And by the time we got back to the lot, the car was gone.
But how is that possible? What did the police say, Sean?
They're in on it.
What are you saying? Sean.
I know.
Hey, Holden.
Holden.
Yeah? And leads?
Take over a beer.
So, obviously, they're fucking in on it. Can't say I'm surprised. Mexico is a hard place to be a good cop. What about our team?
Well, Border Patrol has them crossing the bridge, her and her friend, at 1900. About a week ago Monday, and they confirmed there was no return.
And they're sure about that?
100%.
So what now? And what are they doing to help?
Well, there's not much they can do. Their reach ends at the border.
Look, she is out there, brother. Right? And we will find her. Look, I mean, I don't know if it'll do you any good, but I was able to get you a meeting with the U.S. Consul General and the other girl's old man, too, if he's interested.
Oh, I've been trying to get in there since this whole thing began, man. I tell you, they haven't even called me back.
Sometimes I guess it just pays to be a charming, sexy-ass motherfucker, you know?
So how did that work with you? I appreciate that. I really appreciate that, brother.
You know, I'm there whenever. Wherever. You know that, right?
I know that.
For me, I forgo all this political bullshit. Roll over there, grab that dirty cop, waterboard the shit out of him until he start talking.
And what if he didn't?
Low torch and pliers.
If that didn't work, then what?
Fuck, I don't know, man. I would light that place up and burn that whole fucking town to the ground.
Well, you hold that thought. I'll do it my way for now, right?
You let me know if you change your mind.
Consul General Marcus Dobson.
Sean Beckwith. This is John Langenkamp. He's Billy's dad.
Good to meet you both. Please, have a seat. I can't tell you how sorry I am to hear about your daughters. I'm a father myself. Look, I wish I could say this type of thing was something incredibly unusual. But I can't. Since this past fall alone, 23 Americans and at least 400 locals have gone missing.
Okay, so what can you do?
There isn't a great deal we can do. Unfortunately, most of the authorities here are in bed with the cartel. Can't really blame them. Most people would rather take a bribe than a bullet.
What do you mean?
6 months ago, a tough-talking new police chief got himself elected. Later that day, a truckload of gunmen blasted into his house in broad daylight. They killed him, his wife, and his four children. The guy was just trying to do the right thing, and by sundown, he and his entire family were dead. You see, it sent a message. In Juarez, you either get on board with the cartel or...
So are you saying you think this cartel might have something to do with what happened to our girls?
It's a possibility. Or perhaps it's just as likely your daughters went to that party, took a hit off the wrong joint, and OD'd. Someone panicked.
And... We doesn't do drugs.
All right, if you say so.
I just did.
Well, if it was a cartel, then they've probably been taken to one of their safe houses until ransoms are paid.
No one's asked for any money.
Shit, I don't have any money, even if they did. But yeah, we've heard nothing.
War?
Or what?
Your daughters are beautiful girls. Maybe someone grabbed them and shipped them off to one of the clubs.
Clubs? Jesus.
Look, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to be insensitive. Like I said, I have a daughter myself. I would want someone to be straight with me in your position.
This Juarez cartel. Who are they?
They call themselves Los Mercenarios. As bad as it gets. Known for their brutality, their shock and awe tactics.
Shock and awe?
Beheadings, torture, you name it.
They're all ex-Mexican military.
Former counter-narco commandos. Many of them are even trained by our own military at Fort Bragg. Only now they've gone rogue and ply their trade moving narcotics, sex trafficking, and gun running.
It sounds like you're telling us there's nothing you can do.
Look, I don't think you understand, Mr. Langenkamp. This is literally one of the most dangerous places in the world right now. Just this last weekend, there were 39 killings, including the murders of three police officers. The two of you just coming here and poking around? You're playing with fire.
She's an American citizen, General. She's my daughter.
Look, I know your background, Colonel. These guys are savages. Every bit as ruthless as what you faced in the sandbox. Don't make the mistake of underestimating what I'm saying here. They've got connections on both sides of the border, and trust me on this. They don't care what color your passport is.
for your help.
Mercenario is a business first, Colonel. You get in the way of that business. They sense a threat. I think there's an example to be made in any way.
Look at where we are. This is insane. Look, I want Billy back too, as much as you want Lee, as much as any father would, but... Sean!
Two South Texas girls are missing in Mexico, and their parents believe it may have something to do with the local cartels there. Lee Beckwith and Billy Langenkamp, both 18, are believed to have crossed the border into Juarez early last week to attend a party, and haven't been seen or heard from since. Lee Beckwith's parents, including her father, Colonel Sean Beckwith, a decorated former United States Marine, held a press conference at their ranch earlier today and made an impassioned plea for both girls.
My daughter didn't just disappear. She and Billy didn't just up and run off without a word.
Someone out there knows what happened, where they are.
We are begging for the same return of both Lee and Billy,
wherever they might be. We, as well as the Langenkamps, just want our daughter back.
If your daughter should be listening to this right now, is there anything you'd like to say to her?
Lee, we love you so much.
Oh, yeah,
Lee. I'll find you, wherever you are, whoever you may be with. I'll find you.
Tenemos un problema, y necesito que lo arregles.
¿Saben por qué están aquí?
No haríamos nada para insultar a los señor Garza. Por favor, díganos lo que cree que hemos hecho.
¿Te acuerdas de esas chicas americanas que me trajiste?
Sí. Eran nuestros regalos para usted, para los mercenarios.
Lo que tú llamas un regalo, yo llamo una carga.
¿Qué? ¿No te gustaron?
Sí. Sí, me gustaron. Muy bonitas. En eso, sí elegiste bien.
Entonces no entiendo.
Pues, compadres, parece que el padre de una de estas chicas es un ex militar americano que acabo de ver en las noticias en vivo buscando a su hija y amenazándonos.
Pero nosotros no sabíamos. ¿Cómo íbamos a saber?
Pero nosotros no sabíamos cómo íbamos a saber.
Tú eres como un perro que se me ha cagado en la alfombra. Y la única manera de hacerte entender en el lío en que me he metido es poner esta nariz tuya.
¡Puta mierda!
Lo que este americano no entiende es que nosotros mandamos mensajes a cualquier persona que nos amenace nuestro negocio y que nos haga ver como pendejos. ¿Entiendes?
Sí, sí, sí.
¿Hiciste?
Sí, entiendes.
Carlitos, quiero que juntes un grupo de nuestros hombres y que cruces a Texas por los túneles. Ya estando en ese lado, te vas a encontrar con otro de nuestros contactos que te va a dar la información de este americano y su familia. Él ya los ha estado siguiendo. Y tú, quiero que me traigas la cabeza de este americano para poder hacer una ofrenda, un sacrificio a la Santísima Muerte. Ahora saquen a este policía de mierda de mi casa, que ya no lo quiero ver.
Gracias, señor. Gracias. Gracias. Gracias, señor. Gracias. Gracias, señor. Gracias. Gracias. Gracias, señor.
El mensaje que mandamos es que si le podemos hacer esto a este ex militar americano, se lo podemos hacer a cualquier otra persona en el mundo. El miedo de ellos es el respeto de ellos. Esta es nuestra declaración y quiero algo especial.
Así va a ser, hermano. Va a ser especial.
Siempre he confiado en ti. Y me haces orgulloso.
Una tequilita.
Got them so riled up.
No, you're not.
they say.
Really?
I got nothing, Susan. My words have no meaning. I'm worthless.
No. No, you don't get to do that. It's not fair, Sean. You don't get to shut me out. You're not the only one missing a daughter.
I'm sorry. You're right. You're right. I'm sorry.
I know. It's killing me. I just have to have faith. What's going on?
Coyote.
Listos. Me pasé toda la noche en esto.
Multiple systems reeling on high band. Latest military grade jammers, 360 coverage. Other than your team's radio frequencies, there ain't any calls coming in out of that ranch.
You have vecinos?
Mire. No hay nadie.
Listo. Vámonos.
listo para la sorpresita.
¡Susan!
Mom?
Yeah, honey?
What's going on?
It's nothing. It's Dad. He's just looking for a coyote.
Susan!
Vamos.
The fool's dead.
Get away from the window. Go upstairs, get my gun in the office.
Sean, what's going
on? Fucking go!
Hey, baby. No. No, of course I'm not at Manny's. You know I can't eat that garbage. Yeah. No way. I know, right?
Dispatch to Sheriff Riggins, do you copy? We have a report of shots fired. Over.
Hang on, baby. I got a call coming in. Go for Riggins, over.
Sheriff, we have reports of automatic gunfire at the Beckwith Ranch.
Wait, what?
The call came from Bill Mitchell. Heard what sounded like a full-fledged gunfight coming from the Beckwith Ranch.
Heads up! That's up!
Quiero que aseguren la parte de atrás de la casa. Nadie sale vivo de aquí, ¿entendido?
Seguro, jefe.
Entendido. Espera mi señal.
Estamos esperando.
Esto apenas empieza.
Bueno, entramos y atacar y se acabó.
Nunca subestimes un hombre que pasó la mayoría de su vida trabajando en una profesión en la que usualmente los hombres se mueren muy jóvenes.
¡Shut! ¡Está arriba!
¿Qué chingados estás esperando, cabrón? Ándale. Ándale, cabrón, camínale. No seas putito. Ándale, hombre.
The window now!
O te mueres, cabrón.
¿Cuánto ya?
¿Lo ves?
Sí.
¿Qué está haciendo?
No más aquí. Por un rifle en mi cabeza.
That whip? Really? That's your plan? Threaten to shoot the guy I sent up first.
The same guy I almost killed him myself last night. ¿Qué chingón eres, cabrón? Eres un chingón.
Carlos.
Tenemos un problema.
Carlos.
¿Cuál es el problema?
Es la policía, coronel.
Es un coche y un oficial acerca de la puerta principal.
What the hell? Sheriff Riggins, the dispatch, over.
¿Qué chingados está haciendo aquí?
Está intentando hacer una llamada.
No pasa nada. Que no salga vivo de aquí, ¿entendido?
Sí, jefe, puede dejar de aquí, no sale.
Riggins, the dispatch, over. What the hell's wrong with this piece of shit?
Los ojos y les voy a dar a comer a mis perros. ¿Tienes una hija? ¿Ah? ¿Ah? Go to the truck.
How about you?
I can't leave him alone. Go!
Sean! Sean!
Oh.
Go, go, go!
My daughter. Where is she?
Fuck you. You're a dead man. You and your whole family are dead.
I'm giving you one more chance. My daughter. Where is she?
No! Wait! 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 Los policías, they took her, your daughter and her friend. They were giving us gifts.
To who?
To my brother, Victor! He's the leader of Los Mercenarios!
Where do I find him?
In Juarez! I can take you down there. We own the whole city. You will need me there.
Don't leave. You can't just leave me out here.
Okay. I won't.
Suzanne! Now! Come! Come, come! Let's go! Now! Come!
Lauren, baby, now. Stay with me. Come on.
Let's go. Get it. Come on. It's okay. It's okay. Come on.
Here you go, baby. Listen. I need your phone.
Okay.
Who's ever still out there, and they're not going to be looking for this truck. So you drive right to the Rizzi's place. You go slow and steady. Do not stop. Then you call the police.
Sean. No. I'm not going to lose you, too. What are you going to do?
I'm going to get Lee.
Sean!
Yeah.
You remember the way you said you played?
I remember.
You ready?
You just say the word.
Look, they found me. The scum that took Lee, they found me. They came to my house. They came after my family.
Jesus, man, are you all right?
I know who they are. Victor Garza. Mercenarios cartel.
Okay, where are you?
The old big chief off 86.
Let me just get my gear. That's our boy, Victor Garza. Story of his exploits occur on Maggot's stomach.
Yeah. As it gets.
And that is his address. Exactly a secret. As far as he's concerned, he is unfucking touchable. Good reason, I guess. He's got an army. Yeah.
How are we gonna get all this in?
Nobody trying to keep shit out of Mexico. Just shit leaving. We ain't bringing this back.
Look, this is probably gonna be it. I need you to be sure. You sure?
You know what? I'm almost offended you gotta ask me that.
Let's go.
Thank you.
sí quiero saber dónde está. ¿Cuál es tu pinche trabajo? Quiero que me encuentres a mi hermano ya.
And how many you figure he is with him?
10, 20. With a QRF of another 50 on standby.
And how much time you think we have once they know we're inside?
Before the QRF is on us? Maybe 10 minutes, gear up, get their shit together.
Look, whether she's alive or not, nobody's getting out of there.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't have it any other way. You're not looking for a hug right now, are you?
Jesus.
Fuck.
It's John.
Entra.
Ni señas de Carlos y los demás.
No mames.
Tal vez los pescó la policía.
No. No. Carlos haría que lo mataran primero. Salte. ¿Qué carajo está pasando?
No sé. Quédese aquí, jefe. Yo me encargo. Se los colaron invasores.
Encuéntrenlos.
Ramírez, ¿qué sucede?
Ramírez. Este es el comandante Garza. Están atacando mi hacienda y necesito que encuentren a cualquiera de mis hombres y los junten a todos.
Yes,
están. Idiotas.
Don't move.
Drop it. Drop it.
What do you want? Money? It's yours.
Name your price.
Nah, there's not enough money in the world for you to slip the reckoning you got coming. I don't even know who the fuck you are.
You remember me?
Wait.
Where's my daughter?
Where's my brother? Oh, Santissima Muerte has blessed you this day.
You better tell me she's alive.
Okay. She's alive.
Hurt my daughter, you fucking motherfucker!
I swear to you.
What? Send your fucking dogs to my house!
What?
What did you say?
She is alive!
Where?
I can take you to her.
Where? Where?
At the Angel Tower.
Sean, we gotta roll.
She's close. She's very close.
Let me tell you something, motherfucker. You're lying. You're gonna fucking regret me not finishing off right now.
What's with the severed animal heads and the gory altars on the side of the road, huh? Hey, fucko. I'm
talking to you. They're offerings.
Offerings, huh?
Muerte.
Who?
The patron saint of death. We pray to her for protection.
How's that working out for you, huh?
What we do is against God. So we can only pray to her to watch over us. When we die,
waiting for us inside.
I don't know. I'm guessing most of my men are on the way to the hacienda.
What's your signal? You have a special knock signal?
Yes.
¿Dónde están las muchachas? Las muchachas americanas, ¿dónde?
Diles, diles.
Sake.